Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, we'll be learning how to add a UTM campaign parameter to your product URL. So without further ado, let's jump into our site and learn exactly how we can do this. To add a UTM campaign parameter, go into one of your existing feed. In this case, I'll choose custom one. Scroll all the way down and go to the filters tab. Under the filters tab, you'll see this option that says campaign URL builder. As you can see, the first three parameters here are compulsory and you do need to fill them up. These two are optional parameters. So let's go through the parameters one by one and see exactly how you can set it up when you're creating your feed. The first field that we have here is campaign source. So the campaign source identifies the advertiser, the site, and the publication. Some examples of campaign source would be Google or newsletter. Let's say in this case, we're trying to create a campaign for our winter sale and we want to do it through mail. So for campaign source, we can put in winter mailer as it's for a winter sale and you want to do it through emails. So this is going to be our campaign source. Now let's move on to campaign medium. Campaign medium is basically the way you want your campaign to be transmitted to your customers. So some examples of campaign mediums are CPC, banners, or email. In this case, because we've decided on mailer, our campaign medium is going to be email. The campaign name is basically the name you want your campaign to be identified as. You can use a product name, you can use a promo code, or you can use a slogan as well. In this case, since we are trying to promote our winter products, I'm going to name this winter sale. Now we have the field campaign terms. If you want particular keywords to be identified in your campaign, you can add them here. And then we have campaign content. Now if you're running multiple ads or campaigns, you can use this field campaign content to differentiate between the different ads that are running. These two fields are not compulsory. So for now, we're going to keep them as it is, and we're going to scroll down and update and generate feed. Once the feed has been generated, let's download it and have a look. There you go, guys. As you can see under link here, we can see our campaign URL showing up. Under our campaign URL, we can see the UTM source is coming up as winter mailer as we have put in our filter. The winter medium is email and the campaign name is winter sale. And as you can see, if we look at other products down here, we can also see the URL showing up for them as well. There you go, guys. This is how to add UTM campaign parameters to your product URL when you're creating your feed. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.